My name is Lynette McDermott. I'm with the Hamlin YMCA. I'm the Community Relations Director. And I'm going to be interviewing Frankie Elliott. And he is a volunteer. And he wants to tell his story to us.
And my story is I'd like to see a bunch of seniors get back out there in the pool, do your exercise and bowling. And we've got all that here at the YMCA. We can get a bowling instructor out here, I happen to know one personally, and we can get involved with teaching you how to bowl. Just be a member of the Y. Come on out here to the swimming pool. Swimming's a lot of fun, and I think you'll enjoy it. I've been here 27 years, and I can't believe how fast the time has gone, and I enjoyed every minute working here in this environment, because this is the place for young people to grow up and get the foundation and build up their character. I've been a member of the Y for many, many years, and if it wasn't for the YMCA, I have no idea where I'd be today. Maybe in jail. Didn't say that either. But I'm encouraging all the seniors out there, if you want to learn how to swim, we'd be glad to teach you. Swimming and bowling is what I've been doing for many, many years, and I'm certified on both ends.
So how long have you been a member, Frank, here?
I would say close to 27 years.
27 years? And what did you do here as volunteering?
I was a swimming instructor, and then I was a lifeguard.
And did you only volunteer here, or did you volunteer otherwise?
Well, I volunteered on several Ys around the country, because when my wife and I were traveling the country, we would go up to Sacramento and visit friends of ours, and I would go to the Y there, and Rio Linda to the Y there, and wherever there's a YMCA, I volunteered. I was teaching people how to swim, how to breathe, and a lot of them were scared of the water, but when we got through with them, they were having more fun than kids were. And I'm talking about seniors too, having a good time. Don't be afraid of the water, we can teach you. That's what we're here for.
And what are some of your hobbies?
My hobbies is I like to bowl, and I play the harmonica. It's by ear. And I do yo-yo tricks too for Duncan Yo-Yo. I was a Duncan Yo-Yo instructor for a couple of years back there in the 50s. And I was a demonstrator for them, and believe it or not, I was getting $25 a week, which is a lot of money, just to go out and demonstrate on Saturdays or Sundays, go to the shows, have an intermission, have a yo-yo contest, give the kids a few lessons and all that, and it was very exciting. I had a very beautiful life on that part of it. I was always helping somebody else, and that made me feel good.
And here are a lot of medals you have displayed. Do you want to talk about these medals in this case first?
Yeah, these medals here in the bottom, they were all for the Senior Olympics in Florida, Lakeland, Florida, and I was I was teaching classes at Lakeland, Florida, Lakeland Y, and I participated in the Senior Olympics, which was held there. And these are the medals I won from Florida, and I came back here, and these are all these medals here are from the Senior Olympics we had here in Lake County and Porter County, but unfortunately they quit doing that several years ago. And we had a good time, all those old people looking at seniors would get together, and we would congregate and talk about the old times and be surprised all the things that happened in our life and the enjoyment we had. But the thing is we would go bowling, get yourself a partner in competition of that. They had slow pitching, they had basketball, everything. We were all looking forward to Senior Olympics every year, but when they cut it out, well, we had to find something else to do. We come back to the Y, take it and take home, do what we have to do. Get our swimming in, get on the air. They got a great exercise room here. This YMCA is very well equipped with the people. They're very knowledgeable, very good instruction. And it's a place to go to relax and, of course, build your body up.
And I understand you taught Kelsey from here, bowling?
Yeah, well, we had bowling in the lessons here for a while, and I had quite a few young people, but I noticed this one girl, Kelsey Tope, and she had a lot of potential. And I am a Junior Olympic bowling coach. I coach the high schools in the area. But when I saw Kelsey out there, she had a lot of potential, so I worked with her as much as I could. She got in high school, and she was on a high school team more than I am. She was outstanding. She won just about everything here that they had to put out, probably a scholarship too. And she went on to college and started bowling there. And she said, "Let's go bowling, coach." I says, "Okay." Well, she keeps on beating me. She feels bad about it. And I said, "Kelsey, you don't feel bad. I feel good. You're beating the coach." So that was a, she's a very nice person, very kind and considerate. Good bowler, very good bowler, and a beautiful person. Kelsey, I love you.
And also you served in the Korean War, as you can see by his hat, and he did go to Washington, D.C. This year. So you want to talk about your experience in Washington?
Yeah, I was starting from taking off from Midway Airport at 4 o'clock in the morning. They wanted us there. And we all got there, and we understand there was 106 veterans. And out of the 106, there was 4 World War II vets. The rest of them were Korean vets. And so they processed us, put us in wheelchairs. I said, "We can walk," but they all wanted us in wheelchairs. Our guardians wanted us. We don't run away or get scared or whatever. But it was very nice. We met a lot of people there, and we had a lot in common. We did a little talking about the good times. We didn't talk about our bad experience there, but we had a great time. And it's called the Honor Flight. They went on to pay tribute to all us veterans that came back that didn't get the respect that was owed to us for what we did. But I was in Korea in the 74th Combat Engineers, right up on the DMZ line with division. And every time they went out, we had to go out with them and make sure that things were adequate so they can continue going forward. And this honor flight was a beautiful thing to them. We took off at 8 o'clock in the morning. We entered the Dulles Airport in Washington, D.C. And there was over 2,000 people that greeted us there. Fire department, police department. I don't think nobody was protecting the city because they were out there paying homage to us and giving us a transportation to the museum, and to the place where the statues are. And we didn't have no stop signs. We just kept going and led to our destination. And we were treated like kings. They really respected us. And we all had some tears in our eyes, joyful tears and bad tears. But we really appreciated this honor flight because it means an awful lot to us, a lot of our GIs out there. And I've been out there doing a lot of campaigning. Went to the VA hospital and got some applications for the honor flight, and I'm passing them out and having my comrades take that flight. And this is the token they gave us, all the veterans, a very nice token. And I have this with me every day. If we ever get into a bar, or happen to be in a bar, and another guy throws his shirt down, if you don't have another one like that, you've got to buy him a drink. And then sit there and talk. That's what that is.
That's amazing. You did a wonderful service to us and to here at the YMCA. We appreciate your service and volunteerism. And I thank you for this interview. And thank you so much, Frank.
You're quite welcome. My pleasure.